Good evening, dear viewers. First of all, wish you a very happy last Monday of the month of Shravan in the Hindu calendar, and also happy Eid to all of you. So keep liking Chance Micro Classes. I'm overwhelmed to see the likes and the views. So today we'll study something about mycology or fungus. So mycology means the study of fungi. The singular term is fungus, and from there the word fungi has come. What is the literal meaning of the word mycology? If you break up the word is mycos plus logos. Mycos means actually mushroom, and logos means study. So in literal terms, the word mycology means study of mushrooms. Why is so? Because we all know that mushrooms are a type of fungi only, and they are a very favorite delicacy in our cuisine. So as because mushrooms are fungus, and the initial scientists of mycology studied mushrooms, so it was superimposed on mycology, as the study of mushrooms became the study of all fungi. So when we are going to the study of fungus, fungus can be four types. One is a yeast. Second is yeast like. The third is filamentous, and the fourth category is dimorphic. This classification is based on the shape and size. So morphologically, fungus can be classified as into these four categories, out of which we all know what are yeasts. Yeasts are something like this, oval cells, large, they can be round also. Yeast like, along with this thing, they produce some elongated structures called pseudo hyphae, or I'll write in short PH. Filamentous fungus has hyphae like this, which is usually having some septa. And dimorphic fungus show different morphologies at 37 degrees Celsius and 22 degrees Celsius. What are the beneficial uses of fungus, and are they prokaryotic or the eukaryotic? Fungi are always eukaryotic, and what are the beneficial uses? Louis Pasteur discovered that it can be used in the fermentation of wine, to produce wine, I mean. Secondly, it can be used as food, mycology, or the study of mushroom. Thirdly, it can be used as probiotics. Fourthly, it can be used in genetic engineering. So these are the few, one of the few beneficial uses of fungi. Also, fungus can be classified on the type of sexual spore they produce. So if they produce it like a sac, it is called ascomycota. if it is produced under an umbrella-like thing or basidium, like mushroom, it is called basidiomycota. And if two haploid cells fuse together to form a diploid zygote spore, then it is called zygomycota or glomeromycota. And a few are not falling into any category, they are called chytridiomycota. So this is all for today. In the next class, we'll study something more about fungus. So what are the take home points? This is yeast. This is yeast like. This is filamentous and this thing, different morphologies at different temperatures, is dimorphic. This is all for today's class. Keep liking the videos and like my video. And also subscribe and press the bell icon. Thank you. Good evening. Take care.